Hi, welcome to Daniel H. Creations. Today I will be changing this princess doll into a scary horror doll. As you can tell, it's in a kind of rough shape here. It was my daughter's old doll. First, I'm going to start by teasing the hair, making it look worse than it already is. And now we have the finished teased hair look. Next, we're going to go on to coloring the hair, making it look dirtier than it already is. In this next step, I am going to dirty her hair using some black tea to give it a little bit of a brown look to it. Now I'm just going to let the hair dry and let the coloring soak into the hair. Now I'm going to paint with black acrylic paint all over the body just to give it a base coat. It will not remain all black. Try to avoid coloring the eyes though. You don't want to touch the eyes. You can tape the eyes if you like. I chose just to try to not touch them. Now, technically, I don't need to color the whole body. The part that's going to be seen is just what's standing out from the dress, like the face and the hands, and a little bit of the legs might show. But I just decided to do the whole thing just to see how it would turn out. Now I decided the hair needed something more, so I added black paint to strands of the hair to give it a little more texture, make it look a little creepier looking and dirty. This is the finished hair look. So I was going to spray paint the shoes, but my can of spray paint of silver had a clog in it. So I'm going to use a paint marker instead that's a silver color, like a dark charcoal. Has any idea how to remove a clog from a can of spray paint, you can please leave a message in the comments. Thank you. Thank you. For myself, coloring the shoes isn't really necessary because I'm gonna keep this doll on my second floor window in my bedroom, and so that way people can see it from the road. So the shoes will never really be seen. The bottom part, people will never see. Here's a finished shoe product that I'm just gonna leave to let dry. Just using products that I have on hand, I'm gonna use a can of white spray paint to change this blue dress to white so it doesn't look like Elsa's dress anymore. Now that the white has dried, to make it look a little dirtier, I am adding coffee grinds and rubbing it into the dress to give it more of a antique, dirty sort of look. Now I'm going to use Folk Art Crackle Medium. I'm going to place that over the entire body. It's just a clear coat that once we use our top paint color, we'll give it a sort of a crackle kind of look to make it look more antique and older looking. For the next step, after the crackle paint has dried, I'm going to use my vanilla acrylic paint and place all over the body. Now I'm just going to smooth out my vanilla paint with a paintbrush. Next, I'm going to use my metallic charcoal paint marker. I'm going to color around the eyes, and also I'm going to trace where some of my crackle marks showed up on the face, just to give it a little more definition and more depth. Next, I'm going to use a red paint marker to color in the lips and the fingernails. Now I'm going to go back into the face and do a little bit more of the dark charcoal metallic color on the face to give it a little more character than what it currently has. Now I'm going to take a rose metallic paint marker and just add a little rose on the cheeks here. Next, I wanted the doll to look a little less happy and a little more sinister. So I'm just adding some of the charcoal to the lips, giving some crack lines here and a little bit more of a sinister sort of smile. Next, to her dress, I'm going to add a little bit of red food coloring. Let's give it a look of like a little bit of blood. Be warned with food coloring. It doesn't really dry well and it can be very messy. I'm using very small quantity here on the dress and being very careful not to touch it or it will get on everything. And here's the finished doll look. I am pretty satisfied with it. My kids and the neighborhood kids think it looks pretty creepy. And remember to subscribe to my channel. I will be doing some other future creepy videos on making some Halloween decorations for indoors or outdoors.